sometimes when you meet other letterboxers or when you go to events, people like to exchange their personal stamps. Like to just set up, I don't know why do you do it? I don't know. It's part of the fun. You get to, it's part of the community. You get to,
it's like finding a letterbox, only you find
a person. Exactly. And so then you get to get their, and some people have really nice ones. I have just a stamp that I bought from Michael's. But, you know, other people have their hand carved ones, which are amazing. Like
that's my first one.
That's your first. That's the first stamp you ever made.
Awesome.
Okay, and Sue, you can explain to everybody why you're not wearing your Viking helmet.
Oh, I have no good reason. Yes, sir.
That is better.
So we thought that maybe it would be a good idea to talk a little bit about why we think it's important for social workers, you know, to dress up like Vikings or, you know, anything else really.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the thing is social workers tend to be a little serious. You know, the work that we do is very important, you know, the work of social change and stuff. And, you know, we deal with people who are really marginalized, who are going through, sometimes, you know, we're dealing with people going through the worst periods of their life ever. And even if you're doing community work, you're working with folks that are not always, you know, in the best of circumstances. So, you know, it's easy to get down on ourselves, right? I know that we talk a lot about the importance of self-care, for example. But also we talk about the importance of being able to connect to people in general, right? And I think that being able to take the serious out of yourself, being able to make fun of yourself, being able to kind of think outside the box and be creative and silly and ridiculous and play, these things help us to do those things. They help us take care of ourselves. They nurture our inner child, children. Well, some of us maybe have more than one. But also, in addition to nurturing our inner children and giving ourselves room to play and experiment and have fun, I think it also helps us to not take ourselves too seriously and not, you know, keep constructing that professional demeanor, you know? In doing so, we learn to connect with other people, too.
So when we were across the street at, you can see it in the far distance there, we were at the Armory Place trespassing, and we saw this tower in the background, but we decided, you know, we'd leave it alone. So while we were letterboxing, it brought us right back to this tower, so we are now trespassing again, and taking a look at this tower. It's pretty cool.
Locked, because I'm totally going up the stairs.
All right.
You know what? I should take
this place. Careful not to fall through. I think what I really like about geocaching or letterboxing is finds like this. I mean, you spend so much time trying to navigate the different streets of a town, you don't really start to get to feel the heart of the town, and some people might think I'm crazy for thinking this is the heart of the town, but it's something that you wouldn't approach otherwise unless you had sort of Viking discovery genes, so to speak. So I think if I can send a message to social workers, it's to continue in their own lives, explore these little areas, and work towards using that knowledge in a good way. Maybe it's a sword that's too much for people.
Swords are too much for people. We need to sheath the sword. Okay, so here we are exploring downtown St. Thomas. Is that the name of the city that we're in? Okay, good, yeah. And Anyway, we thought we would explore a little, and we went to this store. I didn't even notice what the name was. I just saw
Angels in Avalon.
Angels in Avalon, and it looked like the kind of place that I am interested in. And anyway, so yeah, I'm being told to hurry up. So what happened was we came in, and we happened to mention to, and I'm sorry, I don't know
anything. Bernadette.
To Bernadette here, that we're on a letterboxing adventure today, and she happened to say, oh, I have a letterbox, and I thought, oh, okay, all right, what is that? So it turns out that there is a letterbox planted here in the store, planted by the same folks who are organizing the event today, and we are going to stamp in and out, and it's pretty exciting to just randomly discover that. I had no idea this was here. Benefit is of letterboxing, of geocaching to a community, and something I've been thinking about is just I'm suddenly having this weird feeling of pride about St. Thomas. I mean, I don't know St. Thomas really at all. I know that they've been really down on their luck. You know, they've had a lot of industry leave the town. Economy's not so great, but you know, I'm discovering that there's some pretty interesting people in this town. I'm discovering that there's some really interesting places to go, some interesting parks, interesting monuments. And it's giving me this sense of, like, I would like to know more, you know? Like, I'm starting to feel a part of a community that I'm not really even a part of. And, you know, it's the same thing with Kitchener. When I first started doing letterboxing in Kitchener, I felt suddenly ripped off because I've been living in Waterloo and I had no idea that there was such a rich community in Kitchener that existed. And I think that what's really good about geocaching and letterboxing is it gets you out of your house, it gets you out of the places where you're normally visiting, where you're normally spending time, and you end up going to parts of the city that you would never ordinarily end up in, and you discover things, you meet people, you notice things that you wouldn't normally, because of course you're looking for, you know, that box, that treasure, but and it piques your curiosity, it piques your interest. And so I think that it can not only, engaging this kind of a thing can not only encourage you to get to know the community, but also helps you to observe things about the community that you wouldn't ordinarily.
I think today has been about comfort for me. And I think as someone with privilege, as a social work student even, I've got a lot of comfort in my life. So for me to dress up as a Viking and be at the mercy of everybody, I think that's taught me a lot about how I need to step out of my own comfort when it comes to interacting with my own community. I think that I now might know or have at least come across more people in St. Thomas than I do in Kitchener, which is interesting for 4 hours of work. But I think overall, if I can send one message away, it's not about the costume, it's not about being a Viking and going letterboxing. And to me, as much as it's about stepping out of your comfort zone, stop being so comfortable and start to take some chances and really remember who you are in whatever costume you're wearing.
I have a logbook. I take the logbook with me. What? And
such a loose
bear. Why are you laughing? You're ruining my monologue. And so inside the box is a stamp, and you take the stamp and you stamp it in your logbook, so you have this nice piece of art. But then I also have my own personal stamp that I stamp in their logbook,
okay.
And so it just does a nice.
Chug it like a Viking would. Chug it.
We don't have a beat. That's my first. I don't know how that was.
What are you thinking about, Sue?
I'm thinking. Phrasing. Okay. All right.
You're already rolling.
Am I rolling? Oh, Jesus. Okay.